Hello and welcome kids, once again to your science classes of grade 3. Kids, as you all know, summer vacations are now about to over, so we have to start our science syllabus. It has to be covered now. So for UT1, you have already covered the two chapters, that was the eating habits of animals and living and non-living things. And you all must know that this is our topic 3. That is safety and first aid. Actually, it is chapter 2, but it is our topic 3. Explanation part of this video, in which we have studied about safety at home, safety at school, safety on the road, first aid, etc. All that I have already uploaded before the summer break. Okay, so those students who have not gone through the explanation video of this particular topic, they can watch their class YouTube channel and listen to that explanation video. That is important. First, you have to go through the explanation video of this particular topic, this particular chapter, which I have already uploaded on your class YouTube channel before the summer break. Only the keywords plus book exercises plus question answers of this topic, of this chapter, was remaining, which I am going to cover in this particular class. So let's move on with the book exercises. This was the activity time. Look at the pictures given below. It is in page number 15 of your book. Mark a cross in the box where you think the child may get hurt. So obviously, some of the things which are not safe for the child in those pictures, and besides the box, you have to put a cross. So in the first picture, you can see the child is waving hand outside the window of a moving vehicle. So it is wrong. It is harmful for the child. In the second picture, the child is playing with the scissor and the hammer. These are the sharp objects. The child should not play with this. So it is also cross. This is a good picture because here the child is following the correct thing. He is using zebra crossing for crossing the road. So it is good. In this picture also, the student is jumping on the desk. He might fall down and might get hurt. So it is also crossed. Now, the next book exercise is in page number 17 of your science book. That is, let's recall. Fill in the blanks with the correct words. You have to fill the blanks with the correct words. The words and options are also given here only. So first is, we dash follow safety rules to avoid injuries. So we should. Okay, should will come. Second, we should not play with knives or toys. So we should not play with knives. Knives से हमें नहीं खेलना चाहिए. Knives means चाकू, the thing which your mother uses in the kitchen to cut the vegetables and fruits. Third, we should be dash while walking on a wet floor. We should be careful. Fourth, we should always walk on a dash, zebra crossing or footpath. So we should walk on a footpath. Okay, zebra crossing is meant for crossing the road from one side to the other side. But for walking, it is the footpath or the pavement. Fifth, we should cross the road at a zebra crossing. Coming to the next page number 18, there are the keywords. First is the subway. These keywords you also have to write in your science fair notebook. When you are going to start this chapter, written work, the first thing is that first you will write these keywords with proper date and day. Okay, then you will complete these keywords. And now I hope every student must be having their science course book, fair notebook, everything. So keywords plus question answers will be done, plus diagram work will be done in science fair notebook, while the book exercises will be done in the book itself with pencil only and in a very neat and clean handwriting. So please take care of your handwritings also. Okay, so the first keyword of this chapter is subway. Subway is a tunnel under a road for use by pedestrians. Pedestrians are those persons who walk on their foot. The subway ek aisa tunnel. Tunnel means ek surang type ka. Sadak ke niche ek surang type ka ek passage bana rehta hai, ek way bana rehta hai, jisko ki pedestrians use kar sakte hain chalne ke liye. That is known as subway. Next is footbridge. Footbridge is a bridge designed to be used by pedestrians. Again, it is a thing which is designed to be used by pedestrians. It is where there are very broad roads and it is a very busy road, then At some places, the footbridge is made so that the pedestrians could cross the road easily without waiting for the vehicles to pass by. Okay, so it is made from one side of the road to the other side, and it is above the road. So that is footbridge. Next, it is very important. What is first aid? The immediate help. Immediate means at once. Okay, quickly. Help given to an injured person is called first aid. Injured means the person who has got hurt. So whatever help we give to an injured person, that is called first aid. Next is antiseptic. Antiseptic is a substance that kills germs. Antiseptic means which is against the germs. Okay, it is a substance like in our home we use antiseptic liquid like Dettol, Sablon, etc. So it is a substance, it is a thing that helps to kill germs. Now coming on to the next book exercise, that is, let's answer question number 8. Tick the correct answer. It is given in page number 19 of your science book. First is, we should not touch electric switches with, option is C, wet hands. Gile haathon se we should not touch the electrical switches because we might get electric shock. Second, we should always walk on the footpath. Third, the immediate help given to an injured person is called the first aid. Next, we should play with B, toys. We should follow safety rules at home, school, market, all places. So it will be all places. And kids, again, I'm suggesting you that you please watch the video first and then only you solve your book exercises. Because many a time when you send the PDF of your book exercises, lots of things are mistaken over there. So please look at the things, understand the things and follow the videos properly and correctly and solve your book exercises without any mistake. Okay? Because it's very difficult to check the mistakes in the PDF form over the phone. Okay? So you better be extra careful while solving your book exercises or doing your written work in your notebook. Question number B, write T for tree and F for false statements. So first, we should give immediate help to an injured person. True. On the road, there is no need to be careful. It is a false statement. On the road, there is very much need to be careful. Okay. Third, we should not crowd around an injured person. Yes, true. Because that person will get scared and there may not be fresh air available to that person. So we should not crowd. Crowd means भीड़ इकट्ठी करनी. हमें इंजर्ड पर्सन के पास कोई भीड़ नहीं इकट्ठी करनी चाहिए. ठीक है, उसको रिलैक्स करके उसे कंसोल करना चाहिए. एंड वी शुड गिव इमीडिएट फर्स्ट एड टू हिम. वी शुड नॉट पुश आवर फ्रेंड्स ऑन स्विंग्स. यस, ट्रू. हमें झूले पे या किसी पार्क में अपने फ्रेंड्स को पुश नहीं करना चाहिए. फिफ्थ, वी शुड गेट आउट ऑफ अ मूविंग बस. फॉल्स. नहीं, हमें कभी भी मूविंग बस से बाहर नहीं निकलना चाहिए. फर्स्ट वी शुड वेट फॉर द व्हीकल टू स्टॉप, देन वी शुड मूव आउट. Question number C, name the following. Any two things you should not play with. So blade and scissors, because these are sharp objects. Any one safety rule to be followed in the classroom. We should sit properly on the benches and should not climb on it. Yes, in the classroom, what some students do? They climb over the benches and jump over there. So we should not do that. Okay. We should sit properly on the benches and should not climb on it. Third, two things which are used to clean a bleeding wound. Bleeding means from, wound means ghav, injured part of the body, and bleeding means blood coming out. So such a wound, such a injured part from which the blood is coming out, so what two things we can use to clean? First is the cotton, second is any antiseptic lotion. Like Dettol, like Sablon, antiseptic liquid you can also write, antiseptic lotion also you can write. Now the D part is answer the following questions. Now coming back to the question answers of this topic, of this chapter. So here is the question answer. Where is of your class? Yes. Here is the question answer. Science class 3rd, topic 3, safety and first aid. Question answers. First question is, what are subways used for? Subway ka use kahan par hota hai? What are the subways used for? Answer, subway is a tunnel under a road for use by pedestrians to cross the road. Obviously, in the definition of subway only it is written that subway tunnel hai jo under a road it is constructed for use by the pedestrians, and pedestrians can use it to cross the road from one side to the other. So this is the answer of this question. Next, why should we not touch electric switches with wet hands? Answer: we should not touch electric switches with wet hands as we might get an electric shock. Obviously, because water is also a very good conductor of electricity. So, and electrical switches, they are operated with the help of electricity. So, if we will touch the electrical switches, plugs with wet hands, chances are there that we might get an electric shock. हमें बिजली के झटके लग सकते हैं. So, we should avoid doing it. We should not do this. So, this is the answer. Next, why should we not leave our toys on the floor? Answer: we should not leave our toys on the floor as someone might trip over them. Trip means slip over them, fissal jana. If we will keep our toys here and there in the room, we will not arrange them, so chances are that someone might enter the room and he or she might trip over them, might slip over them, fall and get hurt. So we should not leave our toys on the floor because it can hurt someone. Next question: list two safety rules you must follow at home. Safety rules which we must follow at home are: first, we should not play with fire or near gas stoves as we may get burned. Yes, this is the very important safety rule, especially for the kids, because fire, it is very much harmful if it is not handled properly. So first safety rule, that the children, the kids, or we should not play with these fiery things, gas stoves. We should not go near them because we might get burned with them. Second, we should not run in the house as we may slip or bump into the furniture. Second rule is that we should not run in our house. House is not a playground. It is not meant for running and jumping and all that kind of things, because while running we might bump furniture se hamara sir hamara pair takra sakta hai and we might get hurt. Okay, next question: what is first aid? The immediate help given to an injured person is called first aid. That's I already have explained you during the keywords also. Immediate means at once, turant, quick. So whatever immediate help is given to an injured person, injured means the person who has got hurt, jisko chot lagi hai, before the arrival of doctor hum jo bhi first aid uska kar sakte hain, jo bhi immediate help dete hain, that is only known as first aid. Next, write any three safety rules to be followed on the road. Aapko any three safety rules likhne hain jo ki hum road pe follow kar sakte hain. So three safety rules to be followed on the road are, I have written three but I have written four safety rules, so you will also write four safety rules. Okay, and here also you can make corrections, you can make and you cannot make also. Okay, it's your choice. So three safety rules to be followed on the road are: first is, we should not play or run on the road. Yes, road is not a playground. It is not meant to be run or running or playing. Okay, road is meant for the vehicles or for the pedestrians, and for pedestrians also there is footbridge to cross the road, there is a subway to cross the road, or there is pavement or footpath for walking over the road, and there is zebra crossing for crossing over the road. So we should not play or run on the road. हमें वहाँ जाके खेलना या running नहीं करनी चाहिए. Second, we should always cross the road at the zebra crossing. Yes, because it is very much safe. When you are crossing the road at the zebra crossing, then no vehicle is going to hurt you, because zebra crossing is meant for crossing the road by the pedestrians. So we should always try to cross the road at the zebra crossing only. You all must have seen the zebra crossing, that is white and black strips, they are painted over the road, they are made over the road, and it is meant for crossing the road by the pedestrians. Third, we should always walk on the footpath. Yes, when we have to walk over the road, then we should not walk in the middle of the road, in the middle of the busy road, or in between the vehicles, where the vehicles are coming and going. वी शुड वॉक ओवर द फुटपाथ द सीमेंटेड पेवमेंट जो साइड में बनी होती है सड़क की साइड में दैट सीमेंटेड पेवमेंट और फुटपाथ वी शुड वॉक ओवर देयर ऑन द फुटपाथ नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज वी शुड नॉट ट्राई टू गेट इन और आउट ऑफ अ मूविंग व्हीकल येस दिस पॉइंट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट समटाइम्स वॉट पीपल डू दे ट्राई टू गेट इन साइड और कम आउट ऑफ अ मूविंग बस और व्हीकल ओके We should never try this because it is very much harmful and dangerous for our safety. Okay, we should not let the bus stop, let the vehicle stop and then only you get inside or come out of that vehicle. And you should also not take out your body part out of the vehicle window, moving vehicle window or bus. That is also very bad practice and not good for our safety. So these were the four safety rules which should be followed on the road. So only six question answers were there in this topic, in this chapter. So now this topic is complete. Okay. Already I have uploaded the explanation video, I think in two or three parts on your class YouTube channel. So first you go there, watch the videos, have a quick revision. Then you can read the chapter also twice. You should read each and every chapter or topic which I am covering at least two times. Okay, properly you should read and understand their meaning also. Or when you are watching my lecture videos, then also you can do that thing. You can pause the video and read and try to find out the meaning, tell the meaning by yourself. Reading is very important. Okay, as much you will read, that much concept clarity will be there in your mind. So you just read this chapter first two times, then you just revise and complete your book exercises by watching this video, and then you can start your fair notebook, science fair notebook work. Before starting the question answers, please leave one page. Okay, you have completed your UT1 syllabus. Now after that, in fair notebook, leave one page blank and then only you start this keywords. Okay, because in that page I will be giving you your UT2 syllabus. Okay, so leave that page blank for writing the syllabus, and after that one page you can start this work. Okay, this that is chapter 2, but it is our topic 3. You can start the work with the keywords of this chapters. You can call it keywords also, definitions also. First you will complete this neatly and cleanly. There should be margin line, there should be proper date and day, there should be chapter number as well as chapter name, then there should be heading that you are writing the keywords or definitions. Then after completing these definitions, you can complete these question answers. And regarding the diagram work, you have to make this first aid box in your science fair notebook, where you will be writing this what is first aid question, na? Question number 5. Besides that answer, you will draw first aid box also in the white page. Okay, so this will be the only one diagram which you have to make in this topic, that is the this diagram, first aid box diagram, along with answer 5 only, along with question answer 5 only, you will draw this diagram. Okay, neatly and cleanly, and you will write also first aid box. Okay, so this was the diagram, then question answer, and then book exercises I have already discussed with you. So that's all for today's video and in this topic. Next, we will be starting a new chapter. Okay. And very soon I will be uploading the lecture videos. And now you please start your study work, study routine, and focus on that also. Okay. So that's it for today's class. Once again, I am holding this question answers video so that you can have a better look. So as you can see, I have also drawn margin line. I have written the topic 3, chapter name, heading. So likewise, you will also complete your work. So that's all for today's class. Thank you for the class.